Hey everybody, welcome back to my studio. Today I want to show you how to make this balloon carrot just in time for Easter. It stands a little over 6 feet tall and only uses three kinds of balloons. So follow along and I'll show you how to make it. The first step is to check out the description box below for a list of supplies, as well as a layer by layer breakdown of how big each set of balloons needs to be. There's 5 balloons in every layer of this carrot, and I'll have all of those sizes in the description box below. I'm using 2 air pumps, a hand pump, and electrical pump, as well as my balloon sizer box to get everything sized correctly. So I'm going to start off with my 5-inch balloons, and I'm going to inflate it to 3.5 inches. This will be the bottommost layer of the carrot, and I'm just going to inflate that balloon and then let air out of it until it just fits through that 3.5-inch hole, and then tie off that balloon. I'm going to repeat that until I have 5 3.5-inch balloons before I move on to the next size up of balloon. Now the first 3 layers of this carrot are made from these smaller 5-inch balloons, but once you get to the 5-inch size of balloon in the carrot, you have to step up to 11-inch balloons because they're just too big for those tiny balloons. So the same goes for any of these larger balloons. I'm going to inflate it and then slowly let air out until it just fits through the size of hole that I'm currently working on. Now the sizer box I'm using today was a design that I made, but it doesn't have 1/2-inch increments for some of the larger sizes. So for the 5.5-inch balloon and bigger 1/2-inch sizes, you're going to have to use a circle that's slightly larger to estimate that size. So here I'm going to make a 5.5-inch balloon. So I'll inflate it, press it up against the 6-inch hole, and then slowly let air out until there's about a 1/2-inch gap between the balloon and the sizer box hole, and that will give me a 5.5-inch balloon. Now I'm just going to repeat all these steps until I've got all of my orange balloons inflated to the correct size before I start tying them into sets of 5. So you're going to take 2 balloons of the same size and tie the nozzles together to create a pair. Now because we're making a set of 5, we need to add a single balloon to this pair to make a trio. So I'm going to grab one single balloon and then just wrap the nozzle around the pair and then tie those nozzles together. Make one more pair in the same way and then join the pair and the trio together so that the nozzles touch, and then twist one balloon from each of those around each other, and that will secure it into a set of 5. Now go ahead and repeat this with all of your orange balloons so that you have a set of 5 for each layer of the carrot. Next, I'm going to inflate 3 lime green 260s, so there's only about 1 inch of uninflated balloon on the end of that 260, like this. Once you've got that, I'm just going to tie a knot onto the end, and then I'm going to bring the 2 ends together and tie the nozzle to the uninflated portion of the balloon so I get this nice loop. Then I'm going to find the halfway point on that loop and gently tug on it and pinch it so I get this nice leaf shape. And I'm going to repeat this until I've got 3 of these leaves to top the carrot. This design uses a 5-foot tall balloon stand as the structure part of this carrot. This is a design I made, and if you'd like to learn how to DIY one as well, I'll have it linked so you can check out how to make one. So let's get down to the bottom of this and start building our carrot. I'm going to camouflage the base of this stand with a couple sheets of tissue paper that I just cut into a circle, and then cut the center part out so that my center pole can come right up through this tissue paper, but you can't see the wooden base. So once I've got the pole back into the stand, I'm going to start adding my balloons to this, with the first set being the smallest. So this is the 3.5-inch balloons that we tied together in a set of 5. I'm going to lay that down flat, making sure 2 balloons wrap around the pole so that the nozzles touch the pole, and then taking those 2 balloons, twist them together, and that's going to lock the pole between these 2 balloons. Now as you twist those 2 balloons, you may rumple up the tissue paper just a little bit, so go ahead and level that out before you grab the next layer of balloons. So just like we did with the first layer, we're going to put these around the pole so that 2 balloons come all the way around, and then twist those 2 balloons together. Now the important thing to note about adding a new layer is making sure that this layer is slightly rotated so a balloon in the current layer is nestled between the 2 balloons below it. Then we're going to repeat these steps until we get all 12 layers of orange balloons onto the pole, and we'll be ready to add the carrot topper in just a moment.
I wanted to pop in and let you know that I have a balloon recipe to go along with today's project. This is a downloadable PDF that includes detailed supply lists, illustrations, and written step-by-step instructions to get you through the entire project. I'll have it linked below in my shop, Or if you join my Patreon at my Party Maker level, you'll have access to not only today's balloon recipe, but my entire library of digital products. So check out my Patreon membership or the shop below if you'd like to up your party game. And until then, let's get back into the project. The last thing we need to do is add some greenery to the top of our carrot. So the three leaves we made earlier, I'm going to thread an empty 260 right through the center of those, and then tie that 260 around all the nozzles of those balloons, nice and snug, and then bring that over to the top of our carrot. Right in the very center of the top, I'm going to place those balloons, and then using the ends of that empty 260, I'm going to wrap that in and out of a couple of the orange balloons in a figure eight pattern, and that's going to secure our leaves to the carrot. Now, I want to give these leaves a little bit of motion, so I'm going to bend them and gently press upwards and roll it, and that's going to create a soft crease in the leaf. So I've got both sides, press them upwards, and that's just going to give it a fun little bit of whimsy to the top of our carrot.
I hope you're inspired by today's project and give this a try. It was super easy to put together and would have a lot of impact at a party or event. If you enjoyed today's video, hit that like button and subscribe below. And don't forget to check out our Patreon group, where I share behind the scenes glimpses of the projects I'm working on, plus even more event tips and tricks. So until the next time, you can check out some of my other projects over here. And remember, stay creative, everybody. Bye.